Hello students, welcome to Tapasvi School. I, Siddharth Joshi, your English educator, would like to welcome you again in our Active and Passive Grammar series. This is the sixth video in which we are going to continue our active and passive interrogative sentences. In the previous video, in video number 5, we have already discussed some of the essential interrogative parts of active and passive. We have started with the two tenses, that was simple present tense and simple past tense. Now in this video we are going to continue with our active and passive grammar series with interrogative part. So let me start with the third tense here, students. That is simple future tense. So first of all, traditionally, let me give you the active voice structure for the same, students. So active voice structure of simple future tense is, now remember students, yesterday also I told you that this is not the assertive sentences, in which the previous video we have already discussed about that this is the question sentences, right? So whatever the auxiliary would come, that would come at the beginning of the sentence. So here will, shall should come first. Plus subject, plus V1, plus object, plus other words. So this is the active voice structure of simple future tense. Now let me quickly give you the passive voice structure, students. Passive voice structure of simple future tense is, now you only will tell me that in future category of tenses, in active and passive, we have followed one particular condition, students. Which condition is it? Yes, you are right, that in a passive voice structure, shall cannot be used, right? So we will use will only, right? So here will plus object plus be plus V3 plus by plus subject plus other words. So here is our sentence structure. Now let's quickly see the example, students. Example of simple future tense. So here, first of all, see the active voice structure, and I am going to provide you an active voice example only, right? Shall she eat her meal? Question mark. So here is our active voice sentence of simple future tense interrogative part, right? Here I have mentioned shall. So shall is the subject here. Sorry, shall is the auxiliary. She is the object, it is V1, and her meal is the entire object. So here is the auxiliary. Here she is the subject, it is V1, and her meal is object. So now, in order to convert that particular sentence into passive voice, what we shall do? We need to put the object first. So let's quickly swipe out the sentences. Object should come first. First of all, will and shall. So as usual, I put will here. Will plus her meal be eaten by her. This is the sentence. Will, he will here is the auxiliary which we have used. Her is the object. Her mean. Be as it is the again auxiliary which we have taken from the passive voice structure. Eaten is V3 and by her, she will become her when it comes to a end of the sentence. So ultimately this is your sentence ready students, that will her meal be eaten by her. This is the passive voice answer. Now let's quickly move to the next tense, that is present continuous tense. So let's quickly start with that. The fourth tense, that is present continuous tense. Now, let me quickly give you the active voice structure students, but what we shall say, not only active voice structure, we shall say IAV structure. IAV means interrogative AV structure. So, IAV structure for the present continuous tense is, first of all, we should use is, am, are. These are the to be form of verbs which should become the question verbs here. That's why is, am, are has been put at the beginning of the question. Is, am, are plus subject plus V4 plus object plus other words. Let me quickly repeat students. Is, am, are, as these are to be form of verbs, right? So this is a mark will become a question verb here, because question would start from there only. So that's why is a mark plus subject plus V4 plus object plus other words. Now let me quickly give you the IAV structure, that is interrogative passive voice structure. IAV structure for the same, again we will keep is, am, are as it is, because we are not going to change anything in that. Is, am, are plus object plus being, here one another auxiliary would be added, because yesterday also we have discussed about one particular point. When we were discussing about that four of the tenses which is not possible in passive voice, when I was explaining at that time also, I told you that when we need to convert V4 into V3, we need to put one particular auxiliary, that is being here, right? So as it is a continuous tense, V4 will be converted into being plus V3 in passive voice. Now V3 plus by plus subject plus other words. So here is the passive voice structure. Let me quickly repeat for you students. Is, am, are plus object plus being plus V3 plus by plus subject. So now let's see some of the examples. Example. So is Rahul studying his book? So here is your sentence, right? So here, in order to transform it into a passive voice, we need to identify what is subject, what is object here, right? So first of all, let's quickly analyze why is has been put over here, because Rahul subject is a singular. That's why we have put is over here, right? Rahul is the subject of the sentence, right? Studying is before, and his book entire is object. So now quickly see the answer for the same. Answer for the same is, now before we put isamar at the front of the passive voice, we should be very much clear whether the object which we are going to take at the beginning, right, is singular or plural. Then and then only we can put isamar. So here object is his book, so his book is a singular. So without waiting for anything, I am putting is over here, because the object would be singular. So is his book, is his book being studied by Rahul? So here this is the answer. Is his book being studied by Rahul? So here, as it is, as I told you that the object was singular, so I have put is over here, right? His book is the object of the sentence. Being is the auxiliary which we have to use if we would like to convert V4 into V3. So being is the auxiliary which we have put over here as per the structure. Studied is V3. By as it is, and Rahul is the subject. So this is all about present continuous tense, right, students? Now let's continue with the fifth tense, that is past continuous tense. After learning all this active and passive grammar series, you must be very, very thorough with the grammatical topic, right? Active and passive, and not only in active and passive students, but in entire grammatical portion, right, which up till now must have been very, very tough for you, will definitely become very, very easy through these kind of a tips and tricks. Because if you do through the structure, then definitely your grammatical skill will be enhanced. But yes, one thing is very, very necessary, students, that what you need is you just need thorough practice for the same, because ultimately without practice, if you start doing anything and if you do it for the one or two times, right, and then you feel confident that yes, I know how to do it, but at the time of examination, if you quit the practice, right, then at the time of examination again you start fumbling that what was the structure, why should I do it, or how should I do it, I will not be able to do it. Again the same scenario would be repeated. That's why I request you all that whatever you learn, right, you keep on practicing, because this is not the thing which you can learn by one or two particular writing, or one or two times. If you write, then you will be able to do it for the lifetime. It is not like that. You have to do it continuously, then and then only you will be able to understand everything. Now, the fourth tense, that is past continuous tense. So let me give you the IAV structure, students. First, IAV structure. So IAV structure is here. If you can see in just in front of you, present continuous tense which we have done just before some minutes, right? is a one is already written. So what only change we need to do over here? That is, instead of is a man, we need to put was one, nothing else. So nothing is going to change except one particular auxiliary, that is was and were, right? So here I am putting was and were, was, were plus subject plus before plus object plus other words plus question mark. This is the active voice structure. Now if you are talking about the passive voice structure, then IPV structure . So just in front of you the structure is written, nothing else you need to change. You just need to change only is a man from, sorry, you just need to change was were in place of is a man. So again I am putting was were plus object plus being plus v3 plus by plus subject plus other words plus question mark. So this is a passive voice structure, students. Now let me give you one example for the same. Example is were the players playing football . So here is the sentence. So in order to transform it into a passive voice, students, we need to analyze it, right? So here were I have put, why? Because the subject is plural, that's why. What is the subject? The players. So this is plural, that's why I have put were over here. Playing is v4 and football is our object. So now in order to transform it into a passive voice, we need to clear about one particular thing, that whether the object which we are going to take at the beginning of the sentence is plural or singular. So what is the object of the sentence? Football. Now football is the singular, so here I need to put was instead of were, right? So if you can see, that here I am putting was, then football being played by the players . Here is your sentence ready, students. How? Because why I put was over here? Because the object which we have carried at the beginning of the sentence, football, is singular. That's why. So football is the object. Being is the auxiliary. Played is v3. By as it is, as per the framework, the players is the subject. So this is how, really, in a very easy mode, you can frame the sentences, right? Now let me quickly give you the fifth tense, that is present perfect tense. Now we are moving towards the perfect category. Why? Because you must be wondering that, sir, after present continuous tense and past continuous tense, why future continuous tense we have not taken? Because remember, students, what I told you about, that there are four tenses in which passive voice structure is not possible. So here also the same rule would be applied. So future continuous tense we are not taking because in that passive voice structure is not possible. So instead of that we are going to take the present perfect tense directly. So let's quickly start. Fine. So here is the fifth tense, that is present perfect tense. Now let's see the IAV structure, students. As per the tradition, IAV structure, IAV structure is here. See, now we have, as we have moved towards the perfect category, let me quickly remind you students that in perfect category, whether it is a present perfect or past perfect or a future perfect, we are going to use has, have here, and V3 would be common in active voice also and in passive voice also because it is a perfect category. That's why V3 past participle would be common in both the voices, in active voice also and in passive voice also. So IAV structure for present perfect tense is, first of all we should start the sentence with has or have plus subject plus V3 plus object plus other words plus question mark. So here is your active voice structure, that is has, have plus subject plus V3 plus object plus other words plus question mark. So when to put has and when to put have, I think about this you must be clear. If not, then I quickly give you recap about it, that whenever you find the what you can say subject or object singular, or he, she, it, or any of the name or any of the singular subject or object, at that time what you need to put, you need to put has. Or whenever you are finding the subject or object, I, we, you, they, or any of the plural subject or objects, at that time only you need to put have. So this is just like do or does, right? Is and are, just like that you need to put has and have. So let's see the IPV structure. IPV structure of, as usual I am putting has or have at the beginning of the sentence, has, have plus object should be carried forward, object plus one auxiliary would be added, that is been, right? That is the only change between active and passive in perfect category, that been auxiliary would be carried forward in the passive voice structure, right? So has, have plus object plus been plus V3 plus by plus subject plus other words plus question mark. So this is the passive voice structure, students. Now let's see one example for the same. Has she scored good marks in the test? So here is the example, students, and the example belongs from active voice. So let's analyze it, right? Has she scored good marks in the test? So before we move towards the passive voice structure and before we write the answer for the same, let's analyze it. that has here why I have put, because the subject of the sentence is singular, that's why I have put has, then she is the subject. Scored is V3. Good marks is the object, and in the test is the words. So now we have already analyzed the sentence. Now let's quickly write the answer for the same. Again, before carrying forward the object at the beginning of the sentence, we need to very much clear students that what to be put, has or have. So here, what is the object? Object is the good marks. Now good marks is a plural object, so that's why we have to use have. So let me start the question with have good marks been scored by her in the test? Question mark. So this is your sentence ready, students. Again, let me analyze it for you that have, why I have put, because the good mark subject object we have carried forward, and it's a plural, that's why we have put have over here. Good marks is the object of the sentence. Been, auxiliary as for the structure, we have added over here. Scored is V3, will remain as it is. As I told you, in the perfect category, in active and passive both, V3 would be common. By as it is, according to the structure, she was the subject, will become her in passive voice. And in the test, will remain at its place. We don't need to change. So this is the present perfect tense, right? Now let's see the past perfect tense, students. In past perfect tense also, you don't need to worry about, because instead of has have, there is only one change, students. Which change? I think you are already aware about the thing, because in assertive sentence also I told you, when we were doing it at that time also, I told you that there would be only one change between present perfect and a past perfect. That is, only instead of has and have, we need to put had. There would be not even a single change we are going to do in the sentence, instead putting had in place of has and have. Rest of the structures in both active and passive voices will remain same. So let's start. Here is the sixth tense, that is past perfect tense. Now, first of all, let me quickly give you the active voice structure. So, IAV structure, IAV structure is, instead of has have, as I told you, only one word you need to put, that is had, plus subject plus V3 plus object plus other words plus question mark. So as I told you, you can see here the present perfect tense is in in front of you only. So you can find only one change, that instead of has and have, you need to put had, nothing else. So now in IPV structure, what we are going to do, same thing we are going to do, that had would be had also, plus object plus been, auxiliary would be added, plus V3 plus by, plus subject plus other words plus question mark. So here is your structure. Now let's see one example for the same. Let me repeat my sentence, students. Had he eaten the sandwich that day? This is the active voice sentence. Now we need to analyze it. Had as it is, there will be no change whether the subject would be singular, plural, no matter it is, because ultimately we need to put had in both the voices, right? So had would be had as it is. He is the subject of the sentence, right? Eaten is V3. The sandwich is the object of the sentence, and rest would be other words, means that day. Now let's transform it into a passive voice sentence. Had the sandwich be eaten by him that day? Question mark. So if you can see, as I already put the head as it is, because we don't need to do any kind of a change, because head will remain head. The sandwich, as I carried forward, because it is the object of the sentence, that's why being would be added as per the structure as an auxiliary over here. Eaten is V3, will remain same. By, according to the structure, him, he will become him when it comes to the end of the sentence. So it's a subject, and that day will remain as it is at its place, because it's the other words. So now this is the past perfect tense, students, right? Now the last tense, that is the future perfect tense. This is the last tense which we are going to do, students. So now let's move towards the last tense, that is future perfect tense. Now after that, our interrogative portion will be over, students, and then one last portion will be remaining, and that would be very little one. That would be imperative sentences, right? After the completion of this particular tense, let me give you very brief idea about it. So even you must be aware about it, and you must have the, what you can say, your active and passive grammar series would be over then. So let's quickly start with the last tense, that is future perfect tense. So 8. Future perfect tense. Now, IAV structure for the same is first of all, as usual, as it is a future category, that's why we need to put will or shall, students. So will, shall, plus subject, plus have, plus V3, plus object, plus other words, plus question mark. Now you must be wondering that why not has, why only have sir has written. because students in future perfect tense, even in the what you can say in the previous assertive sentences video also I have told you that as far as the future perfect tense is concerned, we don't need to put has over here. Only one particular word would come, that is have, right? Because here we are using another modal auxiliary, that is will and shall. So in so with will and shall, we should always use have. There is no other word has or had should come along with will and shall. So do remember it, that along with will and shall you have to use have only, right? So now let's quickly see the IPP structure for the same. So IPP structure. Now, as usual, the will would the shall would be removed because it is a passive voice structure, and in passive voice structure shall is not considered. That's why will plus object plus have plus been plus v3 plus by plus subject plus other words plus question mark. So this is the sentence, students. This is the structure, that will plus object plus have been v3 by subject and other words. Now let's see the example. Shall they have eaten the mangoes by monsoon end? So here little bit complex sentence I have utilized over here, students, because in order to give you more practice, that's why. Now let's see, first of all let's analyze the sentence. That shall I have used as it is, they is the subject of the sentence, have as for the framework, eaten is the v3 over here, the mangoes is the object, and rest by monsoon end is the other words. Now here in this particular sentence, one by is from the sentence. So when we moved towards the passive voice, at that time one by would come from the framework, and one by we need to add as per the sentence. So there would be two bys, right? So now let's see the answer. First of all, will, because shall is not considered over here, will the mangoes have been eaten by them by monsoon and. So let's see how the sentence has been framed, students. That will as it is, because shall is not considered in the passive voice. The mangoes is the object which I have carried forward, right? Have been is the auxiliary which we have added as per the framework, right? Eaten is the v3. By is according to the structure. They will become them when it comes to a end of the sentence. So them is the subject, and rest by monsoon end is the other words. So let's not disturb them, let them be at their place only. So this is the last tense, that was future perfect tense, right? So in interrogative part also we have covered all 8 tenses. That was simple present tense, simple past tense, then simple future tense, then present continuous tense, past continuous tense, present perfect tense, past perfect tense, and last we have seen the future perfect tense, right? Now in the upcoming video, which is the last video of the active and passive grammar series, we are going to see imperative sentences. Now what is called imperative sentences, students? Imperative sentences means which denotes any order, any command, any request, any suggestion, any advice, right? This kind of what you can say, sentences are considered or called as imperative sentences. Now in that kind of imperative sentences, usually subject is missing, right? So if subject is missing, then how we would frame the sentences, right? Confused? Don't worry, students, we are going to do it with the at most is the way we have done all that, we are going to do it that also. So in the next video we are going to see imperative series, and that would be the last video of the active and passive grammar series. So till then, goodbye and have a very nice day, students. Thank you so much.